गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। इन टुडेज़ लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 12th मैथमेटिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर एक्सरसाइज 8.6। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिड टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 7। आई होप यू हैव नो प्रॉब्लम टिल देयर, एंड यू इफ एनी वन ऑफ यू हैव देन यू कैन आस्क योर व्हाट्सएप। सो टुडे वी स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। What is question number 8? Show that the rectangle of maximum perimeter, which can be inscribed in a circle of radius a, is a square of side a root 2. So first of all, there is a circle in which a rectangle is inscribed. Okay, it is the center of circle. Its radius is a units, so you can see this as a. Now we have to find the perimeter of this rectangle. We can assume length of rectangle is x and breadth is y. Okay, so what we can write, we have a rectangle of length x and breadth y inscribed in a circle of radius a. Okay, now it is a, this length will also be a. Okay, so now in this triangle we can name this rectangle as ABCD. This point we can say O. In triangle ABC, it is a right angle triangle. So using Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. What is AC? AC is this complete length, that is AO plus OC, that is A plus A means 2A, 2A square plus AB is X, so square of X, plus BC is Y, square of Y. So we get 4A square is equal to X square plus Y square. So y square will be 4a square minus x square. Y will be our 4a square minus x square. It will be positive because y here is length and length cannot be negative. Okay, now we have to find the perimeter of rectangle. So perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. Our length is x and breadth is y, but we can use this value of y here, so that will be under the root 4a square minus x square. This is our perimeter. Now our perimeter is in one variable, so we can differentiate it. So what we will get, dp by dx, that will be 2 into differentiation of x 1 plus differentiation of something under root will be 1 by 2 under the root, and it will be in division. What is that? 4a square minus x square. Now differentiation of this will be, of this will be 0, and of minus x square will be minus 2x. These two cancel this, so we get 2 into 1 minus x square under the root 4a square minus x square. Okay, now for extreme values means फोर मैक्सिमा और मिनिमा. वट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू पुट आवर फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव एज जीरो. देयरफॉर जीरो इज इक्वल टू टू इंटू वन माइनस एक्स बाय अंडर द रूट फोर ए स्क्वेयर माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर. दिस विल बी जीरो, सो वी विल गेट वन माइनस एक्स बाय अंडर द रूट फोर ए स्क्वेयर माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर इक्वल टू जीरो. फ्रॉम हेयर वी गेट वन इक्वल टू एक्स बाय अंडर द रूट फोर ए स्क्वेयर माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन दैट विल बी फोर ए स्क्वेयर माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू एक्स. नाउ यू कैन स्क्वेयर बोथ साइड, स्क्वेयरिंग बोथ साइड्स we get. Now if we square something under the root will be cancelled. So it is 4a square minus x square. It is equal to x square. So 4a square is equal to 2x square. Okay. So we get x square is equal to 2a square. By dividing 4 by 2 we will get this. And if we will square root now, we will get the value of x as under the root 2a. The value of x will not be negative because here it is representing some distance and distance cannot be negative. So the value of x is negative. Now we can find the value of y. What was y? Y was under the root 4a square minus x square. X square means root 2a whole square. That will be 4a square minus 2a square. That will be 2a square. That is again root 2a. Therefore, x is equal to y is equal to root 2a. So when in a rectangle we have length is equal to breadth, then we can say that it is a square. So one thing we have proved, that the rectangle is actually a square of side root 2a, or you can say a root 2. Now we have to check whether the its perimeter will be maximum or minimum. So to check whether the point is actually a point of maximum or minimum, we need to find out d square p by dx square means second derivative. And what will be our second derivative? That will be d square p by dx square. That is differentiation of 2 into 1 minus x by under the root 4a square minus x square. Okay. So now we can differentiate it. It will be 2 will remain as it is. Differentiation of 1 is 0. So 0 minus. Now we have to differentiate it by u by v rule. What is that? V square in denominator. V square will be 4a square minus x square. V as it is, v is 4a square minus x square. Differentiation of u. U is x. What is differentiation of x? X is 1. Then minus. Then our u will remain as it is. And now differentiation of v. that is 1 by 2 under the root 4a square minus x square into minus 2x. Okay, this 2 cancel this 2. So at last we got 2 into minus 4a square minus x square again minus x square by 4a square minus x square whole divided by 4a square minus x square. Now you can check a is distance and x is also distance, so they cannot be negative and our numerator is negative, means whole of our equation is actually negative. Or also you can put the value of x, then at last we will get that it is negative, and if it is negative it is less than 0, and if whenever our second derivative is less than 0 then we have a point of maximum there. So what we get, that it is the result that whenever a rectangle of maximum perimeter which can be inscribed in a circle of radius a, radius is a, is a square of side a root 2. Why it is a square? Because this length is also a root 2 and this length is also a root 2. Hence our result. Okay, now our question number 9. Question number 9 is somewhat different from there. That says the perimeter of triangle is 8 cm. Means, first of all, a triangle is given to us. Its perimeter is given. Perimeter of triangle is 8 cm. One of its sides is 3 cm. I can assume that this is 3 cm. Find the other two sides such that the triangle has maximum area. So what I can do? I can assume that this distance is x, this length. So this length will be 8 minus 3 minus x. That is 5 minus x centimeters. Okay. Now we have to find the area of this triangle. How we can find this, the area of this triangle? Area of triangle is equal to, there was a Heron's formula in earlier classes if you have studied, that is under the root s into s minus a into s minus b into s minus c. Here s is semi perimeter of triangle, a, b, c are the sides of triangle. Okay, so that will be, perimeter is 8 cm, semi perimeter means half of it will be 4 cm. S minus a means, a we can assume is our 3 cm, so 4 minus 3. B is x, so 4 minus x. And this is our c, so that is 4 minus 5 plus x. Okay, understood. So it will be 4 into 4 minus 3 is 1 into 4 minus x, x minus 1. Okay, so at last we got 2 under the root 4 minus x into x minus 1. Okay, now it is the area of a triangle in one variable, so we can differentiate it. So dA by dx will be 2 will remain as it is. Differentiation of this complete will be 1 by 2 under the root 4 minus x into x minus 1. Now differentiation of this we can solve by product rule. That will be first term as it is, differentiation of second, that is 1 plus second term as it is, differentiation of first, that is minus 1. Yes. Okay, these two cancel this. So we get 4 minus x minus x plus 1 by under the root 4 minus x, x minus 1. That is 4 minus x minus x minus 1 by 4 minus x into x minus 1. So at last we got 5 minus 2x by under the root 4 minus x into x minus 1. Now 4 maxima or minima means 4 extreme points dA by dx we have to put equal to 0. So 0 is equal to 5 minus 2x by under the root 4 minus x into x minus 1. So we get 5 minus 2x equal to 0. That is 5 is equal to 2x. So value of x is 5 by 2 centimeters. So now we can find the third side. Third side measurement. It is 5 minus x, that is 5 minus 5 by 2, that will be again 5 by 2 centimeters. Okay, now we have found out the dimensions of our triangle. Now we have to prove that whenever its one side is 3 centimeters, that is given, and the other two sides are 5 by 2 centimeters each, then that triangle will have maximum area. So to check whether this point is actually a point of maxima or minima, we need to find out double derivative, that is d square a by dx square. Okay, now that will be differentiation of 5 minus root 2x by under the root 4 minus x into x minus 1. Its differentiation you can do easily, and after doing differentiation you have to put the value of x in it, and after putting the value of x in this, what you will get, that the whole value of this is actually negative. Okay, and because it is negative, it is less than 0. So this is the point of maximum. Hence our result. This was only our result, that we have to prove. We have to first of all find other two sides of the triangle whose base is 3 cm and perimeter is 8 cm, and then prove that this triangle will have maximum area, which we have proved. Okay. Now question number 10, a very easy question. It is saying that prove that the perimeter of a right angle triangle of given hypotenuse is maximum when triangle is isosceles. Okay, so it is our question number 10. They have given us a right angle triangle. We can say it as ABC. Okay, also they have given hypotenuse, we can see it as h, that is a constant here. Now in this we have to prove that this distance AB is equal to BC. First of all, we can assume AB as X and BC as Y. Okay, so what is given to us? A triangle ABC, right angle at B, and AC is equal to H. We can say H units. Now we can assume AB is of X units and BC is of Y units. Okay. Now, because triangle ABC is a right angle, so we can use Pythagoras theorem. So, in triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So, H square will be equal to X square plus Y square. From here we can find value of Y, that will be under the root H square minus X square. Okay. Now we have to find the perimeter of this triangle. So, perimeter of triangle ABC, we can say it as P, is equal to X plus Y plus H. Okay, sum of all the three sides. X will remain as it is. We can put the value of Y, that is under the root H square minus X square plus H. H is a constant here already. Okay, now we have only one variable here, X. H is a constant because they are already given, of given hypotenuse. Okay, that's why it is, we will assume that will be a constant. So we can do its differentiation, dp by dx. So it will be 1 plus of this will be 1 by 2 under the root H square minus X square, and now of this will be minus 2x plus 0 because it is a constant. Okay, these two will cancel this. So you get 1 minus x by under the root h square minus x square. Now for extreme values, we have to put dp by dx as 0. So what we will get? 0 is equal to 1 minus x by under the root h square minus x square. That means 1 is equal to x by under the root h square minus x square. So after cross multiplication, we get under the root h square minus x square is equal to f. Now we can square both sides, squaring both sides, we get, what do we get? H square minus X square is equal to X square. Okay, so H square is equal to 2 times of X square. So X square is H square by 2, and we get the value of X as H by root 2. It will be positive because X is a distance. Now using this value of X, we can find the value of Y. That is, Y is equal to under the root H square minus, what is the value of X? H by root 2 whole square. That is, H square minus H square by 2. That will be again H square by 2. That means H by root 2. So you can see that value of X and Y is same. Means this triangle is an isosceles triangle because two of its sides are same. Now we have to prove that when X is equal to Y, then our perimeter is maximum. So what we'll do? We'll do double derivative of that. That means d square p by dx square. That means d by dx of a first derivative. And what was that? That was 1 minus x by under the root h square minus x square. Okay. So it will be differentiation of this is 0 minus of this will be you can do by u by v formula. That means v square, v is our denominator, that means h square minus x square. Then our v as it is differentiation of u, u is x, that will be 1 minus u as it is differentiation of v, that is 1 by 2 under the root h square minus x square into minus 2x. These two will cancel these two. So what we get at last? Minus h square minus x square plus x square by under the root h square minus x square whole divided by h square minus x square. Okay, now we can take LCM of h square minus x square. That will be minus under the root h square minus x square. It will be h square minus x square plus x square divided by h square minus x square. This x square will cancel this x square. So you get at last minus h square by h square minus x square power 3 by 2. Why? Its power is 1, here its power is 1 by 2. And now this will be in multiplication. So whenever base is same and powers are different, in multiplication they are added. So you get this. Now here you can put the value of x, and at last you will get that our double derivative is negative. Negative means less than 0. And whenever our double derivative is less than 0, then we have point of maximum there. So that means this, whenever a right angle triangle is given to us with given hypotenuse, its perimeter will be maximum whenever the triangle will be isosceles, means the other two sides of triangle will be equal. So you can solve these 10 questions in your fair notebook and try further questions. Okay. Thank you.